On today's episode of Food Nerd, we're going to be talking Doctor Who. For our recipes today, we're going to be making a carbonara with face of bow tie pasta. So put on your 3D glasses and your fez, because today we're going Doctor Who style, today on Food Nerd.
Doctor Who first aired November 23rd, 1963 on the BBC. The story follows a being called the Doctor in his adventures through time and space. Though he looks human, the Doctor descends from a race called the Time Lords from the planet Gallifrey. He is the last of his kind after the fallout of the Time Wars against the Daleks. Throughout his adventures, the Doctor travels with people he meets along his path, and they journey with him. These individuals are called companions. They journey together through time and space in his ship called the TARDIS. Yes, that blue phone box you've seen pop up everywhere. The series has been around for over 50 years, making it the longest running science fiction television series in history, according to the Guinness World Records. The Doctor has taken on many phases during his life due to his ability to regenerate when he dies, with his latest regeneration happening on the latest Christmas episode. So, if you haven't jumped on the TARDIS bandwagon yet, it's not too late. And don't forget to ask yourself the oldest question in the universe. Doctor Who?
Now, what seems to be the problem?
I shall come back. Yes, I shall come back.
Alright, let's turn up the heat and get a pot of water on to boil. Then we'll start by chopping up about 6 pieces of bacon. We'll add that into a pan. Then we'll chop up some onion and we'll add that into the pot as well. Next we'll add some salt into the pot, a little bit of olive oil, and then we'll add our noodles. Next, we're gonna crack about 4 eggs. And we'll give those a nice whisk. Then we'll add in about 1 teaspoon of flour. That way the eggs won't overcook when they get in. Then we'll add some thawed out frozen peas and we'll bring that heat down. We're going to add some boiling water to the eggs to temper them so again they don't cook as soon as we add them to the pot. We're going to add our noodles in and give those a nice stir through, making sure that they're completely coated. We'll take those off the heat. Then we're going to add our eggs. The residual heat from the noodles and the bacon will actually cook the eggs. Then we'll add a little bit of Parmesan cheese into that and give that a nice stir through. And there it is. Carbonara with face of bow tie pasta.
Freeze in the pan!
For today's Flash in the Pan, I'm going to do a quick rundown of my top 5 favorite companions.
Number 5, Donna Noble. She was the second companion to accompany David Tennant's 10th Doctor. With her quick wit and sarcastic banter, she made a great counterbalance to the sometimes childish Doctor. Donna's journey only lasted 1 season, which I thought was a good run for her. Number 4, number 4, Captain Jack Harkness. A lot of people may argue that he was technically not a companion, but in my books, he traveled with them enough, so why not? Jack had the ability to time travel on his own, but he preferred the journeys of the Doctor instead. He continued on his own adventures in his series, Torchwood. Number 3, Clara Oswald, the Impossible Girl. Clara is the newest companion to the Doctor. With her infectious grin and adorable charm, it was hard not to fall in love with her quickly after her introduction. And we now get to see her interaction with a new Doctor. There are exciting things in store for this young lady in the future. And her integration with the Doctor's history will be an interesting storyline to follow. Number 2, Amy Pond. This fiery redhead always kept the Doctor on his toes. The Doctor had always played an integral part of her life from the time she was a young girl to her adventures with him as an adult. After a hint of romance at the beginning, things became awkward after she brought her new husband on board the TARDIS. Amy was the longest running companion on the new series so far, with 2.5 seasons under her belt. Well done her. If I was the Doctor, I would have kept this redhead around a little bit longer. Last but not least, number 1, Rose Tyler. For a lot of us, she was our first. Rose was the first companion that we saw in the new incarnation of the series. Starting with Christopher Eccleston's number 9 Doctor, following into David Tennant's number 10. At least in my heart, she will always be the number 1. And her final scene with David Tennant is probably one of the best scenes in television history. Her connection with the Doctor was unparalleled. And when she made her triumphant return in the 50th anniversary special, I was bouncing in my seat like a little kid. Rose Tyler, you will always be my number 1.
That's it for today's episode of Food Nerd. I hope you enjoyed it. To all my fellow Whovians out there, have a happy holidays and have a great new year. Make sure you guys stay tuned with us throughout the next year. We're going to have some exciting new things coming up. If you did enjoy today's episode, hit the like button down below, hit subscribe over there on the side, and keep watching. Check out the blog. We are going to have more updates coming, I promise. Some big changes happening in the Food Nerd right now. And gearing up for it. So stay tuned with us, and until next time, we'll see you guys later.
And that's it, I'm afraid. There's no more from you on the transcript. That's the last I've got. I don't know what stopped you talking, but I can guess. They're coming. The angels are coming for you. But listen, your life could depend on this. Don't blink. Don't even blink. Blink and you're dead. They are fast, faster than you could believe. Don't turn your back. Don't look away, and don't blink. Good luck.